NY Free Ice NYC. It was Shut It Down NYC. We took the streets in the third poorest congressional district in America. And the whole neighborhood was united behind Honest Nieto. Yesterday, I had the honor of being at a Martin Wood Coalition meeting and experienced so much solidarity from that group, seeing all these organizations working together for a common cause.
This is a relatively recent addition.
What?
A relatively recent addition.
Yeah.
To the family.
8 months. Yeah.
Hi, what's your name?
Ava.
Hi, Ava.
It affects all of us everywhere. There's somebody right now being harassed or beat up or shot by a cop. We have to be here every second of every day in the streets. It is our duty to do so, because tomorrow it could be any one of us. It could be any one of us tonight. Akai Gurley met his peace with the police on November 20th, 2014. He was killed in East New York in the Pink Houses complex. The only thing that man was doing was going down the stairs. Because as you know, in these buildings, sometimes the elevator doesn't work. And your choice is to go down the stairs. He was going down the stairs with his loved one. And it was a dark hallway, because they don't care about our community. They don't care about our people and the conditions that they live in. And instead of making it to the lobby, he was shot by Officer Peter Liang. And instead of getting help from a police officer who's supposed to be trained in CPR, he was supposed to look out for the community. He was left to bleed out on the ground. He was bleeding and sitting in his urine. His friend was the one that administered CPR. And what did Liang do? He walked around his body. He went downstairs and called his union representative. He went up the stairs to go look for the bullet shell. He argued with his partner on what he should do so he wouldn't get in trouble. And yet they're calling this an accident. No, you allowed this young black man to die on your watch. You were trained to do something else, but we know what police officers are really trained to do. They're trained to occupy and oppress. They're trained to shoot first and maybe ask questions later. Right now in New York City, we had a 2-week trial. Liang was convicted by a jury of his peers. The DA, who was supposed to be working on behalf of the family, recommended 5 years probation, 6 months house arrest, and $500 of community service. So, basically, within this system, you kill a black man on the street, you kill a Latino man on the street, you get to sit in your house. Yet Akai left his family and his daughter. He will never see them again to get to sit in his household. But you get to. You're a murderer. You're murdering our people. But you get freedom. So what we're doing now in New York City, we're waiting for April 14th, 13 days, for Judge Chun to make a decision on what Liang's sentencing is going to be. We're putting pressure on this judge, because he has a duty to our people. He has a duty to sentence Liang to prison time. Because if it was any one of us, they would have built the prison on top of us. We know this. Because he is no longer a police officer and a citizen, he deserves his jail time and he should be treated as such. So I want to say thank you for all the cities, because it's not just San Francisco. Tomorrow in New Haven is going to be an action of solidarity for Akai. Los Angeles is having an action of solidarity for Akai. Sacramento is having an action of solidarity for Akai. And New York City, we're going to have our own on the 9th. We need to support each other no matter where we are. Like I said before, it could be any one of us. We're standing here, we're holding signs, and we plan to march. Who knows if we're going to make it home later because of police brutality.
Okay.
And it's not just a young people thing. People of all ages are getting hit with this epidemic. It's an epidemic. It's genocide. We have to fight, family. We have no choice but to fight, family. I'm Akai. You're Akai. We're all Akai. Mauro is Akai. is a Kai. Sandra Bland is a Kai. Chantel Davis is a Kai. Eric Garner is a Kai. As long as there's a body on the street, there all are Akai Gurley. Thank you so much for standing here and showing solidarity to a struggle that's in the East Coast. But because we understand what solidarity is, it's on all coasts. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. And I have to say this, Hortensia Peterson, whose auntie's, who we call her auntie, she's Akai Gurley's aunt. Akai Gurley's mother is in Florida. She comes up when she can with her family to support Akai. But the struggle has really been through myself and other organizers and auntie bringing the news back and forth to his mother. She's isolated there. One of the things that she told me to tell the city of San Francisco and everyone who's standing in solidarity for Akai is thank you so much. She says she loves you for standing for her nephew. She says she appreciates you for the struggle that you're bringing here. She says she understands the struggle and has solidarity for everyone who has faced police brutality within this city. I'm not making this up. She's very religious. Trust me, she put in some Bible verses and everything, but we don't got to take it there. But I'm letting you know that she said thank you from the bottom of her heart for the solidarity. Thank you for the love. And I want you to know that your struggle here in San Francisco is taken back to the East Coast with me. So now we're going to have, thank you for listening. Because y'all didn't have to. Y'all could be like, all right, Kirby, thanks, long-winded. Right now we're going to have my comrade Frank Lauder get on the mic. Give him a warm up.
All right, thank you for that, Kirby. Bueno, yo voy a dar mi presentación en español porque obviamente estamos en la comunidad de la misión, una comunidad históricamente latina, y es importante que todavía a nuestra gente trabajadora que está llegando del trabajo, después de trabajar 8 o 10 horas, que se nos una. Si está bajando del bus, que se nos una, para que aprenda qué está ocurriendo en este país. Nosotros sabemos, con lo que está pasando con Trump, el racismo que se ve, que no solamente es la presidencia de Trump, pero que también estamos hablando de una política que está en cada departamento policial. Aquí en San Francisco ya van dos veces, dos casos, donde la policía ha sido investigada por sus textos racistas. Ahora imagínense, esta es gente armada. La policía es gente armada que según ellos deben estar siguiendo la ley. Y sin embargo, con esa política racista, nos juzgan a nosotros en nuestra comunidad. Estamos en un barrio latino que lo están desplazando, los están corriendo, los están empobreciendo, los están quitando los derechos a nuestra gente. ¿Y qué pueden hacer? Poner más policía. Yo soy un maestro de aquí de la escuela Buena Vista Horace Mann. Cada vez estamos sufriendo porque no hay suficientes servicios para nuestros niños. Pero ¿saben que hay dinero? Para policía. ¿Saben para lo que siempre hay? Para un nuevo, para darle más salario al jefe de policía. ¿Saben que en mes de febrero, hace dos meses cuando estaba el Super Bowl, escucharon que Super Bowl estaba aquí en San Francisco? ¿Sí? Ok. En febrero, la policía cobró $5 millones extras en su servicio policial. 5 millones en un mes. Imagínense qué puede hacer con una escuela. Mi propia escuela con $100,000 solamente diera dos consejeros y ayudaríamos a la gran mayoría de nuestros estudiantes latinos. Pero ¿qué va a pasar? En vez de eso, 5 millones se da a la policía. Entonces estamos aquí hoy porque están ocurriendo esas marchas por todo el país con un muchacho llamado Akai Gurley. Pero no solamente es su caso, es una epidemia que está ocurriendo por todo el país, dado el caso de Alex Nieto, a Milcar Pérez López, nuestro compañero guatemalteco que hace un año, fue balaceado por la espalda. Esas son cosas que uno escucha de Centroamérica, que según hay matanzas que ocurren. Los escuadrones de la muerte, aquí hay escuadrones de la muerte y se llama SPD, es la policía de San Francisco. Y si vamos a luchar contra esos escuadrones de la muerte, tenemos que estar unidos como un pueblo, tenemos que estar conscientes de que es nuestro interés
y luchar unidos, compañeros y compañeras. Vamos a tener varias oraciones, vamos pláticas. Vamos a comenzar con una dicha que dice: How do you spell murderer? S-F-E-D. How do you spell murderer?
S-F-E-D.
How do you spell murderer?
S-F-E-D.
How do you spell murderer?
S-F-E-D.
So now when I say how do you spell murderer, you say N-Y-P-D, because that's what we're trying to do. How do you spell murderer?
N-Y-P-D.
How do you spell murderer?
N-Y-P-D.
All right, brothers and sisters, our next speaker, Kashara White from the Black Radical Organizing Collective.
Collective, and I just have a few remarks about, you know, what's going on in Philly, and as well what we as the Black Radical Organizing Collective see as the movement forward. It really saddens me today to see yet another rally demanding justice for yet another black person who has been killed by police in a city that's over 1,000 miles away from my own. In Philadelphia, we are up against one of the most oppressive police forces in the country. The Frank Rizzo regime that strip searched young black men publicly in the streets and dropped a bomb on a residential black community is still alive to this day. In Philly, we struggle against this racist and repressive police system. When Brandon Tate Brown, a young black man, was murdered by two police officers, Nicholas Corelli and Hang Dang, he was murdered for driving while black. In northeast section of Philadelphia, and his mother found out about his death on the news the next morning. She was not informed officially by police. She found out about her son's murder as she was driving to work and heard it on the radio. The police leaked information and demonized Brandon Tate Brown in the public, saying that he was armed and he was going to shoot police, and that's why police shot him. When there was found that there was a videotape of the shooting and of the altercation that police insisted was violent on the part of Brandon Brown, the police refused to release the tape. A struggle between the police and the community ensued for the release of those tapes. And eventually, the community won the struggle, and now there's a fundamental problem with that win, because now that the tapes have been released and a lot of information about who the cops are, and now we know who the police were who killed him, which the police have been keeping a secret, the struggle has been stagnant and is ended, and nobody is supporting in the same way that we're here today supporting Akai and others. Nobody is supporting Brandon Brown's mother or his death to this day. And so some community folks and I got together and we decided to try to assess the situation. Why was it that this really robust movement ended up fizzing out of nowhere? And we gathered together at Temple University at the Black Radical Tradition Conference starting on Thursday, January 7th this year. It was a historic achievement in the highest order. It was powerful congressional leaders, activists, and people fighting for social change in their communities dedicated to their lives and liberating humanity. Anchored in revolutionary love, the conference represented the unity within Black Philadelphia and the activists around the nation in challenging white supremacy and capitalism, and it anticipated the next stage in Black liberation. What we found out in this conference, the reason why Brandon Brown, the struggle to get justice for Brandon Brown, the reason why it fizzled out was because it was too focused on police reform. It was not And also very focused on the legal case, the legal proceedings of this particular case. So what we realized is that if you want to struggle alongside people, poor people, Latino people, black people, that you need to know who they are, their day-to-day struggles, not just when one incident pops up and you want to go and run and support them. You need to know their lives. The fact that Brandon Brown's mother found out that her son died on the radio was not lost upon us. And today, I stand here with you saying that we have a lot in common in Philadelphia as well as here in the Bay Area. And it isn't just the repressive police or the violence or the poverty, but the resistance in the streets. Across the country, our people have been fighting for liberation, and in fact, we have a tradition of radicalism that spans all the way back to the Middle Passage. And we know that the struggle for black lives is not just about police reform, but about liberation and freedom for all. The vocation of the black radical tradition is the liberation of black humanity as a part and parcel of the liberation of all humanity. Ashe. No justice!
No peace!
I say no justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
I say no justice!
No peace!
My voice cracked, I'm sorry. Might be getting sick. Not sick of y'all, sick of the system. Okay. So I just want to say one quick thing before I introduce the next person. I love that there's a lot of women in the crowd. Women have always historically been in the forefront of every struggle. And the reason why I mention this is because when we talk about police brutality, we say his name, but we don't remember her name. Or we don't talk about LGBTQ members who are also killed by the police. Or we don't talk about gender non-conforming people who are also killed by the police. So we have to be very careful when we talk about this struggle, because when she said we have to liberate all people, that is true. We are all oppressed within this system. And the system does a good job at dividing us and making us think that we don't have anything in common, when we have everything in common because we're human and we deserve better. So the next amazing person I'm going to invite up. Oh, one more thing. Please sign up. We want to keep in touch with you. I want to keep in touch with you. Let's keep building. Let's keep networking. If you see anybody with a clipboard, if you see anybody with a card, sign up. Give them your information. We won't stalk you. If we do, it's for the people, so respect it. Also, take flyers, please. There's actions happening all over the city. I was at one meeting. I got 20 dates in April. I don't even live out here. So please stay involved. So the next person I have coming up is Iman Kalia from Answer PSL LA. Please welcome.
Good evening, everyone. Wow, it's a very crowd. My name's Iman. I'm a member of the Party for Socialism and Liberation and a member of the Answer Coalition. So this rally, as we all know, is part of a national mass protest against police terror and specifically the murder of Akai Gurley by Peter Liang in New York. It's important that we do this all over the country because this is happening all over the country, right? Police terror is an epidemic that has plagued so many of our communities everywhere. And I want to mention briefly the importance of these rallies and this sentiment, not only all over the country, but all over the world. I'm Palestinian. I lived in Palestine for most of my life, and I witnessed the occupation of my city and my country by Israeli forces, and I witnessed the brutality that came with it. This is not unlike the occupation of police in our communities here. They are given free rein to harass and even now murder anyone they think is a threat. Alice Nieto was murdered here in San Francisco simply because a racist police officer was enforcing the rule of the rich developers and gentrifiers who are stealing this community's land and homes just like Israel does in Palestine.
Hell yeah!
The Israel Palestinians are murdered because they think we're a threat. And here, you're murdered and targeted if you're black and if you're brown. We must stand up to gentrification, to the colonization and the occupation of our communities. We must stay united because together we can demand that Peter Liang and all murderous cops get the punishment that they deserve. Thank you.
All right, thank you for that, man. So our next speaker, as we said, right now we're in a moment of uniting. You know, the justice for Mario Woods, the justice for Alex Nieto, the justice for Mica Perez Lopez. Really, there's a unity going on, and that's what we're celebrating today. The next speaker is representing the Alex Nieto Coalition. His name is Edwin Lindo, but you also need to know that he's running for District 9 supervisor here, this district right here. This brother's been standing at every police brutality demo, so give it up for Edwin.
I want to bring my sister up here as well. I want to first say that I wish I could fill the shoes of the Nieto family, but I can't. I'm just speaking humbly on their behalf for the Nietos and that coalition, because what they're going through, what Glenn Woods is going through, what the Mitchell family in Guatemala is going through, it is reprehensible. You have folks that are getting killed every day, and I wore this shirt today on purpose, and I went to work with it, and it says, "Keep calm, I'm not armed." Because what happened to Alex Nieto is that someone, due to the gentrification, people feel they're unsafe for no reason at all except that they haven't been in our community long enough to get to know their neighbors. And so what I'm trying to say is that we need to come together. We had the Alex Nieto Coalition with the Mario Woods Coalition, and we got married. We had a ceremony. The black and brown community came together and said, "We are wedded till death do us part." We're no divorce. And we are going to stand together, walking through the streets, demanding justice. We have the three demands, but I'm telling you that the city is not ready to see black and brown communities and Asian communities. And honestly, it is an issue of poverty as well, because many of our communities that can't afford to live here are getting kicked out, but we're the ones who are getting over-criminalized. Mm-hmm. You know, it is a direct path. We say school-to-prison pipeline. It is dead real. There's a reason that the police are over-criminalizing our communities of color, because it is a protection of the economic interest in the prison industrial complex. And we really have to focus on those issues, because if we don't look at where the money is, then we won't understand why it's happening to us in this community. The last piece I'm going to leave you with is that we have to stay together. We have to, and that's why the wedding was so beautiful, but we have to stay together, because I've heard the rumors. I've heard the discussions coming out of City Hall, and the discussions are the police department hears this very clearly, that the police chief knows what is happening, and that this police department is scared.
Okay.
Because they know that our feet on the ground are going to change and bring a revolution that they haven't seen before.
Yeah.
But what does that look like? And what we need to do is not only focus on the police department, but there's a POA, the Police Officer Association, that has been prohibiting us from essentially providing the reforms we need in our city. But you have this union that has the guns in their holsters, telling elected officials that they can't stand with the people. And to me, if that's not intimidation, then I don't know what is. So please, we can't let up. We can't let up at all. We can't let up today. We can't let up tomorrow, because they're waiting for us to stop marching. They're waiting for us to stop demanding. They think this is going to disappear tomorrow. We can't let that happen. And so what I want to know is, when there's no justice, there's what?
No peace.
No justice?
No peace.
No justice?
No peace.
Amor para Alex Nieto.
So, one of the things I do want to say is that black and brown solidarity has always existed. History has shown us this. It's not impossible. Because when I study, I see these figures working together and coming together. And I see it now today. Look at this crowd. Look at us. This is the most powerful thing that we can do as fighters, is unite. And this is what they're scared of. So please give yourselves a round of applause again. So the next amazing person that's coming up to the microphone, she has been in a struggle for decades, longer than some people here have been alive. She is a revolutionary. She is a communist. She is also running. I know people talk about Bernie Sanders. That's a whole nother action. We don't have time. But Gloria LaRiva is running under the Party for Socialism and Liberation presidential ballot. She's She's a candidate for president. And she is doing work everywhere across the country. And she has been all over the world promoting a different system. So please give her a warm welcome. Gloria! Hermanos y hermanos que están escuchando, la gente que habla español aquí en la misión, estamos aquí en una protesta nacional, especialmente aquí en San Francisco, pero a través del país, desde Nueva York hasta Los Ángeles, para exigir el fin de los asesinatos de los jóvenes negros, latinos, de toda clase de joven por la policía. Estamos aquí hoy porque un joven en Nueva York, en su apartamento, caminando en la escalera del pasillo, fue asesinado simplemente por ser negro. Y estamos exigiendo hoy porque el juez posiblemente no le va a dar una sentencia de prisión, aunque fue condenado por asesinato. Eso es un ultraje que no estamos aceptando, y por eso les pedimos que después de los discursos que nos siguen en una marcha pacífica pero disciplinada hacia la 16 y luego volviendo acá para exigir el fin de la brutalidad policial, para exigir el fin del abuso que sufrimos aquí en la misión, simplemente porque los ricos quieren dominar y controlar este área y echarla, se lo decimos. Aquí estamos y no nos vamos. Y si nos echan, pues regresamos. Sisters and brothers, we are here, as you've heard from other speakers, to demand the imprisonment of the cop Liang, who murdered Akai Gurley, a young man who, with his girlfriend, a father, was walking in the stairway of an apartment building in New York City, and the cops gunned him down like we've seen thousands of times in the last few years. We are fed up, and I'm so proud that here in the mission, there is a strong coalition of activists, of the people, of the common people here who've been persistently demanding justice, not only for Akai today, but for Alex Nieto, who was waiting to go to work and got gunned down by a whole group of cops. Justice for Amilcar Perez Lopez, who was down here on 24th Street in Folsom, and Greg Sewer, this chief of police, who were demanding be fired and also imprisoned, jailed, put on trial for justifying every cop murder.
Come on.
And in other words, you know, the police union is not a union in the sense of defending workers' rights. The police union is in complete union with the police chief and all those higher-ups who see us as the enemy, especially black, Latino, other youth of color, and working class white kids too.
That's right.
And all of us together, as Kirby said, we are every nationality. We are women and men. We are young and old, mostly young, and I'm so glad to see that. But LGBTQ people, we're so solid that we have more power than these cops, and they're worried about this struggle. The only reason that there has ever been any conviction or trial of a cop has been the people demanding it. Never. You can never depend on an independent investigation. And then, when you have a trial and a conviction, to show how outrageous it is, the prosecution is asking for the cop who murdered Akai Gurley to go free. To go free. What does it tell the other police in the United States? You can do it and get away with it. Every time they get away with it, they get away with it again. From L.A. to San Francisco to Albuquerque, everywhere I could mention a dozen places. 1,300 people murdered last year. And how many excuses? Oh, she was backing up. There was a woman in Albuquerque, young, Latina woman, who they claim was backing up in her car. No, she wasn't. Even if she did, so what? They gunned her down. 27 people murdered in Albuquerque. We know our own stories here. Little. Andy Lopez, a 12-year-old up in Santa Rosa. And it's a justified murder by the cops.
snow way. So when we march tonight, I want you to think about this. We're not only marching against the police and the brutality, we're marching against gentrification. That's the reason why Alex Nieto got murdered up in the Vernal Heights.
That's right.
Because some newcomer, some, you know, person who doesn't know our community was
That's
afraid
right.
of a man up there who was brown. This movement for justice.
That's right.
And I would say this. Join the party for socialism and liberation. Because what we need is revolution. No more just fighting for reform. I've been to Cuba many times. And I have never seen an example of police brutality. And I can say that definitively. I have a friend who's a cop in Cuba. He's retired, but he was a police for many, many years. And he's a black policeman. And he said to me, listen to this. He said, the day that we raise our gun against the people, the revolution is finished. Could you ever hear a cop saying this? That the system is finished the day that we raise our gun against the people? No. They use the cops to repress us. And in Cuba, they are liberated. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Gloria. If you want to support her campaign, she's under the California Peace and Freedom Party. Please sign up, get more information. This is a unique moment. You got to join an organization. If you're not part of one, join an organization. Meet the people who are here. There are many activists. Get involved. We're the Answer Coalition, the Party for Socialism and Liberation. Right now is the time to do that. Our next speaker, Karina Garcia, from Women Organized to Resist and Defend.
Únete, únete a la lucha, únete.
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 Ah, that's what I'm talking about. Thank you. Sisters and brothers, my name is Karina Garcia, and I'm with the organization Women Organized to Resist and Defend. Estamos aquí para apoyar a la familia, a todas las familias que han sido víctimas de esta violencia brutal de la policía en nuestras comunidades. We're here today to support all of the families who've lost their kids, who've lost their dads, who've lost their brothers, their loved ones, to racist police brutality. And we're here to tell them that they're not alone. Estamos aquí para decirles que no están solos. I want you to repeat after me. Let's send that message to the families of Akai Gurley, to the families of Mario Woods, to the families of Sandra Bland, of Mike Brown, of Trayvon Martin, and all of the senseless victims of police brutality. I want you to repeat after me. No están solos.
No están solos.
No están solos. Estamos contigo. Because we know that that's not the only kind of violence that we're facing in our community. There's other forms of violence in our community. Hunger is a form of violence. The fact that there are so many people in this country who are forced to see so much wealth and go to bed hungry. 1 in 3 kids go to bed hungry every day in the richest country in the world. That's a form of violence. La pobreza también es la violencia. El hecho de que tantas personas sufren de hambre en el país más rico del mundo, ese es un crimen. Pero ese es un crimen del capitalismo. That's a crime of capitalism.
That's right.
The fact that our communities are humiliated for the pennies that they get in welfare. The fact that they make us sleep on the streets when they pay us poverty wages.
Come on.
When they pay us poverty wages.
Come on.
No health care, no benefits. The fact that our parents are humiliated by ICE and threatened to be separated from their families. That kind of violence that mothers and parents, when they take their kids to school in the morning, have to send their kids with a little note. Because they don't know if they're going to be able to pick their kid up after school because they're afraid that they could be deported. They're afraid that they could be separated from their families. That's the kind of violence that we're talking about. It's not just the legal system, it's the political system too. And that's what we're fighting for. So when we're here today, we don't have any illusions that this is going to be the only march that's going to change everything. We don't think that. That's not why we're here. We're here and we're making a revolution. That's what we're here to do. Because we're tired of waiting. We're tired of seeing our communities being humiliated, demonized, disrespected day to day. And we need a new system. And that's not going to come because one day they take pity on us. That's not going to come because one day they regret all of the humiliation and the brutality and all of the senseless suffering, right? Because we live in the richest country in the world, but if you look in our communities, you wouldn't know. You wouldn't know because we're forced to suffer for no reason.
Right.
We are here to build a revolution. We do need a revolution. We need bold change. We are tired of waiting. So we want you to join us. We want you to join us and be a part of this organization, be a part of this movement. And this is not the beginning. This is not the end. This is a continuity. This is a continuation of this struggle that we have to keep building in our communities, building leaders, training ourselves. So if you're not in an organization, join one. And if you didn't bring anybody here today, you need to bring people here to the next one. Because this is a movement, right? This is not a moment. This is a movement. This is not a moment. We want you to join us. We want you to be part of this movement. No more. Thank you.
They say get back. We say fight back. They say get back.
We say fight back.
They say get back.
We say fight back.
They say get back.
We say fight back.
Get back.
Fight back.
Get back.
Fight back.
Get back.
Fight back.
Get back.
Fight back.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to say one more thing with what Karina's saying. It's only through struggle that anything we have now, we have it. Only through struggle. And if we want freedom and we want liberation for real and we want justice, we have to struggle. And it's not going to fall on our lap. Because I can't be 80 coming out to San Francisco marching for somebody else.
Come on.
Only through struggle will we win. So the next person, I didn't mean to yell at y'all. She just kind of touched me. All right. The next person that we have is Alex Berliner. I probably said the name wrong, family. Please don't kill me. From All of Us or None. Please welcome Alex.
Hello, everybody. How y'all doing? So, I just want to say today is April Fool's Day. The only fools are the motherfucking police. Okay? So, I come from an organization called All of Us or None, and we are a group of former captives of the state. We're all formerly incarcerated people, our family members, our loved ones, and we're still fighting for those who are still inside. We got people inside right now in Pelican Bay, SHU, and CIW, CCWF, all up and down the state being tortured by the police on the inside. And why we come together to do this work is because we understand that all these murders that are happening on the street, those are happening on the inside as well. Everybody who's being murdered on the street, they got murdered because they didn't get taken to prison or jail. And this whole system is connected. They are, like my brother Edwin was saying, that the police brutality that's happening in our community, the hyper-criminalization of brown and black people in our communities is connected strictly to the ethnic cleansing of our communities. They don't want us here. Ed Lee does not want us here. Steve Sir does not want us here. Scott Wiener does not want us here. Damn near the whole Board of Supervisors does not want us here. But we're not going anywhere. We're going to fight this system, and that's why we need all of us. That's why All of Us or None is about All of Us or None. We recognize that it's every single person, including those who are stuck behind the bars and in the belly of the beast. And we all need to come together and rise up and recognize that these people, police are not police, they are slave catchers. And there's nothing more, nothing less. They are nothing but slave catchers. They want us all living in an open-air prison. Mumia talks about this being an open-air prison. If they tell us we can't walk across the street without getting a ticket for jaywalking, what kind of world do we live in where they tell us how we can walk, talk, and act? We can't live in this type of world. We're going to create our own world. So we need to come together to rise up and remember that all of this is connected. All of our hyper-criminalization and the ethnic cleansing of our community is connected to all of the struggles that we're going through. So before it was illegal to be brown and black in this community, now it's illegal to be brown, black, or poor. So all of us, like, including everything that was going on with the Super Bowl, like, I went down to the Super Bowl, they were arrested, one of my comrades, for taking pictures of the snipers. Mind you, you have all these other people posing with the people with the military guns as if this is some sort of, like, America's Next Military Top Model. And we have to remember that the reason why we're homeless on these streets is because they don't want to give us any resources. Ed Lee says that it's our problem that we become homeless and that he tries to give us services to get us better and everything, and then we go back out on the street. But the reason why we go back out on the street is because there's no resources for us. Where are the resources going? You keep building all these monsters in the mission. You keep building all the beasts on Bryant. They're building everything. Like, I'll go through this. This is not the same place. We got Mid Cafe across the street. That was a Mid Cafe a while ago. There used to be a beautiful mural across the street. Everything around here used to be so different. And that's why I wanted to get to the point. It's important that we stick together. Like the sister from Word was saying, we have to join an organization, get with somebody, get behind somebody. Join all of us and join Word, Answer, Galaxy as a coalition. We all one fan at the end of the day. Poverty looks the same everywhere. And we have to recognize it's one hood and that we got to push that message out. We got to come together and unify. So all of us or not.
All right, you ready to march?
Yes.
Are you ready to march?
Yes.
You know, in San Francisco, we measure our success by the number of helicopters. But one is actually really good. So just let it, one is really good. The major anti-war stuff, it was like three. But one is really good. So we want to make sure we're loud. Also, people with a yellow vest, when sometimes they tell us, okay, so you need the cops. What are you going to do when it's crime? What are you going to do to protect yourself? We don't need that. We have a community. There are people right now in yellow vests right now. They're the ones going to be stopping traffic. They're the ones that are going to be facilitating and protecting our people. Familia, estamos diciendo cuando dice que la policía, ¿qué les va a dar seguridad? Bueno, nuestra propia gente. Hay gente que tiene ahorita un chaleco. Nosotros necesitamos la policía que los esté moviendo nada. Nosotros vamos a tomar la calle. So please respect that. We're going to start getting position. We have one last speaker before we start marching. Her name is Liz from Revolution Club.
So I know you guys want to march, so I'm going to make it short and sweet. But on April 21st, we have the National Day of Student Action to stop police terror. We're willing to unite with any forces that want to see a stop to this genocide going down against black and brown people across this country. This country was built on slavery. That's a simple and basic truth. And we're not going to get rid of this system until we uproot this genocide. We actually put a stop to it. That's what we're out here trying to do. Put a stop to it. I'm a follower of Baba Vakian and a member of the Revolution Club. If you want to join me, come and talk to me. But we got to let people know and not back down when we say the whole damn system is guilty. I said the whole damn system is guilty. All right. So, remember, April 21st, students got to be on the move. We got to do any kind of action, whether it's shutting down, dying, whatever we can, to put out the question, which side are you on? Which side are you on? Are you on the side of stopping this, or are you on the side of having this continue? So let's march and let the whole city of San Francisco know that the whole damn system is guilty.
So you ready to march? You ready to march? If we don't get no justice, they don't get no peace. If we don't get no justice,
they don't get no peace.
If we don't get no justice,
they don't get no peace.
If we don't get no justice,
they don't get no peace.
How does that matter now?
SSPD.
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 How does that matter now? How you sound?
Gentrified bar, stopping us from marching for justice. We're going to keep standing up, and we're going to keep standing up and fighting back, which is what we have to do. I'm from Washington, D.C., y'all. They used to try to do the same thing to us, pin us in, hog tie us. We fought for our rights, and now we march where we want, when we want, how we want. It's not about some legal code. It's not about some ordinance. It's not about what Chief Sir says, because he's going to get fired anyway. It's about what we say. And if it's shut down, it's shut down. And I say that because you have to feel the power that's inside of yourself, y'all. It's been almost 1 year since it kicked off in Ferguson. Since this whole country has been turned upside down over the issue of police brutality. In Congress, not one piece of legislation has passed to do anything about it.
None.
In basically every state, no legislation has passed.
None.
In basically every city, no legislation has passed.
None.
So who can you rely on?
You.
Yourself. But if we want to rely on ourselves, we have to understand we have power.
That's right.
We are not weak.
That's right.
We are not able to be divided.
Yeah.
And that when we link arms, they cannot stop us.
Right.
Let me, for hundreds of years, movements have been infiltrated, beaten, arrested, and none of that has ever stopped the revolution before. None of that. No matter how many cops they line up here, that is not going to stop us. I tell you, in 2007, I was in Gina, Louisiana, in the deep south. They had framed up five boys. And we went down there, and they lined up just like this, looking real tough, smiling in our face. Those five boys are out of prison, went to college, graduated, all thankfully very employed. So you can look as tough as you want, but the power of the people is unstoppable. And the fact that you got 100 police lined up right here shows that you're afraid of us. Because if you thought you couldn't do something, you wouldn't be out here. So recognize your own power, brothers and sisters. We're taking over streets. We're shutting down streets. We might shut down a bar if we have to. Because you can't just keep murdering people on video and get away with it.
Right.
You can't think that we're going to keep letting you get away with it.
Right.
There has to be some kind of consequence. We have to hit them in the pocketbook. This is capitalism. It works off profit. We have to stop the profit machine.
Right.
When Google can't get paid, when Oracle people can't go out and have happy hour, you better believe they're going to want something to change.
Yeah.
These are going to be gone.
Because
Microsoft couldn't do a happy hour. It's powerful, I think, for us to be out here. I was telling the comrade Ed earlier to see all of the families in the Bay united, a movement that's united. People from Philadelphia bringing greetings and solidarity. Akai Gurley giving us the unfortunate opportunity to be out here. But it's a sign that he is not really dead. Physically, yes. Spiritually, he's still with us because we say his name and it lifts us up to do this work. And all the other names. And all of us coming together from coast to coast. I'm from D.C. You're from New York, Philly, San Francisco, Oakland, L.A.
Albuquerque.
Think about that. That's the whole country. So when we get done tonight, know that it's not a moment, it's a movement.
Yes.
We already got everybody to sit up and take notice about police brutality. We did that. But it's about more than just creating space, y'all.
Yes.
It's about more than just being heard.
Because
at the end of the day, it's not going to be a police chief with a new policy that saves you. It's not going to be a board of supervisors. It's not going to be a congressperson, a governor, and it's certainly not going to be a president that's going to do it.
Right.
They all co-sign.
Yes.
So at the end of the day, we need to get rid of all of them and put all of us in power.
Yes.
That's when it's going to stop.
Yes.
It's a struggle for power over and above anything else. And you see the power we represent just in this small representation, because each of us probably know 5-10 people who is down with this. Am I right?
Yes.
So just in this small representation, we got 100 cops babysitting us. So you know we must be doing something right.
Yeah.
So I'm going to end on that because I know we have some other folks who want to come up and want to speak. But I just want us to remember before I get off this mic that we have power.
Yeah.
We have intelligence.
Yeah.
And if we stand together, we will win.
Yeah.
Thank you.
faces that are walking by and watching us and judging us and making it seem like we're savage and we have no reason to be out here, we align you in the same position as we view these police officers. We do not have time for anyone to sit here and criticize our movement and what we're doing. We don't have time for blindness, family. Open your eyes. You hear these restaurants and these bars. You're talking to these police officers standing right here. And any one of them could have killed a young person out here today or yesterday. Wake up, because it could be you. Don't stand up when it's convenient for you. This is a continuous movement. We have a duty to be out here. It is our lives that are in danger. It is a dire, critical situation out here. When people are starving in the richest country in the world, when people can't afford to go to school, when people are working, can't make the ends meet, it's not because they're lazy. It's because the system wasn't built for you. It's not broken. It's working just fine. Just not for us. And we paid their taxes.
Yes, they did.
Don't get it twisted. You have the power here. Financially,